All preparations for Flight 10 have moved to the launch pad. This brings the mission closer, but there may still be a slight delay. At the same time, NASA is testing Pad 2 and working on plans for future missions to the Moon and Mars. Together, these steps are preparing us for an exciting new era in space exploration. Let's discuss it all in today's NR Studio episode. The biggest news comes from SpaceX, which has scheduled a launch for 6:30 p.m. Central Time on August 24th. This goal is supported by official announcements, such as updates from the Navigation Center, FAA airspace rules, and road closures in Cameron County, all indicating that date. A different FAA notification about a danger zone between Florida and Cuba, which began late on August 25th UTC, has raised questions about a possible delay. This could be due to weather, needing more time for preparations, or simply a scheduling error. For now, SpaceX's official date remains the 24th. Whether it happens now or moves to a later date, one thing is certain. The countdown is almost over, and everyone is watching. Flight 10 is poised to make history. To prepare for the upcoming schedule, regardless of the exact date, SpaceX is making good progress with Flight 10's equipment. Every step is planned, timed, and focused on ensuring the mission is as successful as possible. The most exciting news is that B-16 has been moved to the launch pad. This move was anticipated after the latest ramp closure schedule indicated that B-16's pre-flight transportation would occur between midnight and 4 a.m. on the 21st. After that time, engineers removed B-16 from its cradle on the rocket and placed it on a transportation cradle. They then carefully moved it to the launch site. This was a crucial step, as B-16 returned to the pad after being gone for over 2 months since its last test. The long delay was primarily due to an issue with S-36 that needed to be fixed before the program could continue. Currently, B-16 has everything it needs, including a hot staging system and a flight termination system. These systems are crucial for safety and ensuring the mission goes smoothly. Upon arrival at the launch pad, they placed the booster between the large suction cups that had been prepared for it. It will likely be moved into place soon to join. This step represents a major step toward Flight 10. The booster is already on the pad, meaning final preparations are now underway. The arrival of B-16 is a major step, but SpaceX still needs to complete S-37. The vehicle has already been moved twice for crucial tests, such as static firing and spin prime operations. Engineers are currently closely examining all of its systems. The main areas of focus are the engines, flaps, payload doors, heat shield, and a special pressurized container called the COPV. Installation of additional components will begin soon. This will include the payload release device, the payload, and the final FTS. Once these installations are complete, S-37 will be ready to go to the pad to connect with B-16. If things continue at this pace, the transfer could occur on the 23rd or possibly the 24th if scheduled delays warrant. In addition to preparing the hardware, SpaceX has made significant changes and improvements to the launch pad. Following the last S-37 launch, several test systems were removed. The QD frame and tube were removed, and the ringwall mounts were brought to the Sanchez site to be used for testing S-38. Now that there is more space, the launch pad is busy with focus testing. Two crucial pump tests have been conducted, one on the afternoon of the 18th and the other on the afternoon of the 19th. These tests are crucial to ensure that the fuel loading for Flight 10 is smooth and efficient. Additionally, the QD booster system has been repeatedly tested by opening and closing, demonstrating its stability after undergoing various test systems. These checks are crucial to mitigate risks during launch. Another important step is the arrival of over 20 water tanks on site. These tanks will supply water to the deluge system. This system is designed to protect the pad and rocket during liftoff. With this extra capacity, the system will work more effectively than ever, providing crucial protection for future missions. All of this preparation demonstrates the importance of Flight 10. This mission is more than just a test run. It's a key moment that will change how future flights will proceed. The results will determine whether SpaceX can conduct two more flights before the end of the year. This could include the highly anticipated maiden flight of the Starship V3 spacecraft and the opportunity for S-38 to fly on Flight 11. If all goes well, SpaceX can move forward quickly. However, if something goes wrong, it could change their plans for 2025. Are you ready for this flight? If so, type "I'm ready" in the comments to show your excitement. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel to follow SpaceX's incredible journey. While preparing for Flight 10, SpaceX is also making rapid progress on its new launch site, Pad 2. The site showcases what future Starship operations will look like, and recent updates indicate that construction is well on its way to completion. On the 15th and 19th, one of the biggest tests took place. The gas generator system went live, releasing a thick cloud of smoke from pipes next to the launch tower. This generator is crucial because it will power the pumps that supply the massive water system intended to protect the pad and the vehicle during startup. That system is already expanding. A new water tank was delivered and installed just a few days ago, demonstrating the high demand for Pad 2.
This facility will likely use more water than Pad 1, especially as the number of launches increases. More tanks and fuel will likely be added to keep operations running smoothly. Scaffolding remains on the launch stand and the large blowpipe arm, indicating that work is still being completed. The site is preparing for full-scale testing, as smaller tests are already underway. Pad 2 is crucial because it is closely tied to one of SpaceX's biggest goals this year, launching Starship version 3 for the first time. If flights 10 and 11 go well, the new vehicle could be ready for display before the end of the year. The new booster is nearly complete, featuring improvements to the hot staging system, fuel transfer lines, and updated grid fins. S-39 is making progress, with an improved structure and a more robust capture point for future recovery attempts. So Pad 2 is more than just another place to launch rockets. It's the foundation for the next phase of Starship, enabling fast, reusable, and more advanced flights that will shape the future of space exploration. Now let's move on to the final part of today's update. NASA is undergoing major changes, and its leaders recently stated that they are now focusing more on space exploration. NASA has always managed a wide range of tasks, such as studying climate, observing Earth, sending humans into space, and exploring other planets. However, this balance may soon shift more toward activities beyond Earth. The focus for the next few decades will be on the Moon and Mars, which will shift NASA's priorities and could alter its mission for the long term. Sean Duffy, NASA's acting administrator, has emphasized the importance of focusing NASA's efforts and resources specifically on exploration. In a February 14th interview with Fox Business, Duffy stated that NASA's mission is to explore space, not focus on Earth science. He stated that Earth science, such as climate studies, will be reduced or given to other organizations so NASA can concentrate on spaceflight projects. He criticized what he called the mismatched objectives that have weakened NASA's mission. He emphasized that NASA's true value is helping humans explore space. This position was reinforced on the 18th during a visit to NASA's Johnson Space Center in Houston. Duffy admitted that Congress has given the agency more work to do, but he emphasized that we are the only agency that will explore space. His remarks suggest a larger vision based on the legacy of Apollo. He linked past successes that inspired the nation to current programs like Artemis, which plans to return humans to the moon and eventually reach Mars. These comments align with President Trump's proposed budget for NASA, which includes significant cuts to Earth science programs. The 2026 budget plan proposes a 47% cut in NASA science funding, cutting Earth science efforts by more than 50%. This could jeopardize critical systems that monitor sea level rise, atmospheric carbon, and climate change. During Trump's first term, projects like the Orbiting Carbon Observatory 3, OC3, and the Clario Pathfinder were threatened with cancellation. However, many of these projects managed to continue despite difficulties. With even deeper budget cuts, the future of NASA's Earth science program appears even more uncertain. Those in favor of budget cuts argue that organizations like NOAA are better equipped to conduct climate research, allowing NASA to focus its funding and expertise on missions exploring new areas. Critics warn that the shifting responsibilities could create a risky gap in climate monitoring and weather forecasting. Long-term records rely on years of regular data collection. If this collection is disrupted, monitoring significant changes in the Earth system will become increasingly difficult. Beyond the scientific issues, many NASA workers and contractors involved in Earth science projects are understandably concerned about job security. Despite some disagreements, there are certainly significant opportunities in this new path. NASA's space program has faced numerous delays and budget overruns. The Artemis missions to the moon have been repeatedly delayed, and the Mars Sample Return Program has faced significant time and budget challenges. As competition from countries like China intensifies, particularly with their plans for the moon and Mars, NASA must focus more if it wants to maintain its leadership in human space exploration. Focusing resources on the Moon and Mars programs could help the agency operate more efficiently, accelerate schedules, and keep the U.S. ahead in the new space race. This debate continues. To some, it seems unwise for NASA to reduce its focus on climate science when we face more environmental challenges. To others, making major discoveries in exploration that will re-inspire the country is a crucial step. The question remains, is this the best way for NASA and the United States to move forward? That's it for today's episode, and we'll see you in the next one.